Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arrive. And I love this tune because it's on the one hand so beautiful, on the other hand it's so easy and just played with just two fingers on each hand. There's something you need to know about the strumming and picking pattern, which is quite special actually, I think. We start with the ring finger, the third fret of the low E string, and you pick, or like with your thumb, the low E string, and with your index finger, the B string. And then, when you did that, you hit kind of like the D, G, and B string with your index finger by doing this, okay? Don't do it too loud. Really try to play it smooth as possible. Okay, after you did that once, you go to the open A string and index finger first fret, B string, and you pluck those two strings, A and B, and you do again this, then second fret and third fret on the A and B string with index and pinky, and do the same, thumb and index pick, and then the index strums, and then you move up to the 10th and 12th fret on the A and B string, still with your index and pinky. And then comes the long pattern. It's pick, thumb, and index, and then down, up, and then thumb again, and up, down. Down, up, thumb, up, down. Thumb, down, up, thumb, up, down. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. And then we go to 3rd fret and 5th fret on the A and B string. And we do the simple pattern again by plucking the A and B string with the thumb and the index, and then the strum down with your index finger. It's mostly about the open G string, which is the most important one to hit. Because I also tend to block with my index finger the D string here, so it doesn't get that messy. We go on with 3rd fret, 5th fret, and then 4th fret with the middle finger and 3rd fret with the index on the E string. So this is a tricky part, that your index finger here plucks then the A and E string. But you still do this. So. Then, same thing, 2 frets up. So, and then 7th fret A string and 8th fret B string in the long pattern, and then index finger 1 fret down, so we're on 6 and 8. And then we come back to this one, 5th and 7th fret. And then this one, 4th and 3rd fret E string. And then again this one, 3rd fret and 5th fret on the A and B string. Long pattern, 3rd and 4th fret. 1 fret down, 2nd and 3rd fret. Open A string and 2nd fret, B string. And mute the D string here with the ring finger, for example. And then open D string and 1st fret B string.
first chord again. Okay, from the top, intro. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life, you were only waiting for this moment to arise. Then we have a reprise by doing again. So, but no new chords there. It's just after the vocals ended. Moment to arise. Again here, third fret, second fret, open string, open D string. And the first one, the G one again. And then the second verse. No repetition, but we go to the B part. Eighth fret, A string, the index, and 10th fret, B string. And again, our good old pattern, plucking the A and B string, and then the index hits again the open strings. Then 7-8, 5-6, 3-5, 1-3. Long pattern and 3-5 long pattern. And when you repeat it, the end is a little bit different. So 8-10, 7-8, 5-6, 3-5, 1-3, and then open and second fret, and open D string and first fret B string. And the first chord. Again. And the verse chords just instrumentally played. And to the B part. Blackbird, fly. Tired of whistling, you play that pattern here up here, and then again. But this time a little bit shorter. So you will just find two different parts actually in the song. You have those repetitions here, always have the vocal parts, there's something going on like this. But no new chords or something. Just, you just drop in again here on the third fret of the A string, fifth fret, B string. So that's Blackbird by the Beatles, Wish You Here by Pink Floyd. And in this video, I want to show you the both parts that you got in the whole song. We're not talking about the solo in this video, but the chords that lie beneath that. So we're talking about the intro and the chords that run in the intro below the solo. And we're talking about the chords which you can hear while the singer is singing. Let's start with the first lick we got here. We start, but first of all, for the intro part, leave your ring finger and pinky always in this spot. Ring finger in the third fret of the B string, pinky in the third fret of the high E string, okay? They stay there till we go to the verse. And then we have a run going on there. small lick. Open A string, hammer on into the second fret with the index, and then open D string. And then second fret D string with the middle finger. And then you already have your first chord, E minor 7, great chord. Hit all six strings with down, up, up, down. So, down, up, up, down. Okay, so that's our first lick and our first chord, and we go over to the G chord after that, but we have a little lick between those two chords. So, from the beginning, after the last downstroke, we play open G string, second fret, D string, your finger's still there, open D string. And then when we play the G chord, third fret E string, second fret A string, and those two guys here are still there where they're supposed to be from the other chord. So we have down, up, up, down, lick, up, down, down, up. Those are the first two bars. After we play the last upstroke on the G, we alter the lick we played it the first time a little bit. We add another note before we go back to E minor 7. We start then on the note that we have from our G chord here in the third fret of the E string, and then the rest of the lick is the same. So it's third fret E string, and then open A string, hammer on to the second fret D string, and second fret D string. Then we go back again with our lick to G. Down, up, up, down, lick, up, down, up, lick. Okay, those are the first four bars. We have E minor 7, G, E minor 7, G. And after that we go again to E minor 7, but then the picking is a little bit different and we go to another chord, namely to the A7 sus4, which is quite similar to the E minor 7. Just plays our index and middle finger one string up. So we are in the second fret of the D string, second fret of the G string, and those two fingers still are in the third fret of the B and E string. We don't hit the low E string there. That's a beautiful chord. The lick is, and then we have the A7 sus4. Fifth bar, this is E minor 7. Down, up, up, and then the lick. And now our pattern is down, up, down, up, up, down. And then we have a run, open A string, hammer on second fret, and then open D string again, like in the very beginning, and we go to G. Down strokes on the G before we go to the top again for two bars. Down, 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 up, down, down, up, down. Let's do it nice and slow from the very, very top. Then we start out on the open A string, you remember. guitar solo. After the repeat, you just play one bar G.
So you think you can D.
So we start out on the verse with C.
So you think you can D major. Heaven from A minor. Blue sky to the G. And again to the D. And again to the C. And to A minor again. So you think you can G.
The strumming pattern is pretty easy. Just go for those really slow and smooth downstrokes. Just throw in some one or two upstrokes per chord. Doesn't really matter. The pulse is kind of like don, 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 don. You get the idea. So grab the C chord a little bit different. Take your pinky for the third fret A string and then place the ring finger into the third fret of the low E string, and then you get a massive C major chord. Yeah. Compare it to the normal C. The D chord is supported by the second fret E string. I play it with my thumb and then also the open A string.
Heaven from hell.
And with the A minor, you play just also the low E string. So we have six strings. This is a regular chord for six strings. And again, D with F sharp in the bass, C with a G in bass, A minor with low E string.
So you think you can tell.
And then it goes back to. If you're new to the world of guitar playing and you have trouble doing all these kinds of stuff, check out my free lessons, which you find in the video description. There you get a lot of cool tips how to play the guitar, how to hold the pick, how to grab a chord, and so on. Everything you need. So check that out. Thanks for watching. My name is Hannes Knechtges. See you in the next video. Bye.